few minutes, I'm going to pull out some of your fingernails and I'm going to leave you to think about it. And later I'll come back and I'll slash your eyeballs. Whatever else I do to you after that, I'll pour gasoline into your eyes from time to time just to keep you from passing out.
Vascularization, a finger was inserted into the splenic hilum to isolate the splenic artery and splenic vein. I inserted a 40 millimeter endo-GIA in the splenic hilum, fired and divided. You can see accessory spleen also.
Very sorry, sir.
J&B straight and a Corona.
Would you like to hear the
double absolute martini?
Yes, sir. Would you like to hear the specials?
Not if you want to keep your spleen.
Now then, tell me, what did Miggs say to you? Multiple Miggs in the next cell. He hissed at you. What did he say?
He said, I can smell your cunt.
I see. I myself cannot.
Incision starts at the bladder neck and is made down towards the cuff for approximately 3 to 4 centimeters. We don't make the incision the entire length of the anterior vaginal wall, as this helps minimize the length of incision exposed to the underlying graft. The dissection is exactly the same as one would do for an anterior repair. The bladder is dissected off the vaginal epithelium, down to the cuff apically, and laterally the dissection is taken out to the pelvic sidewalls up to the level of the ischial spines. The retropubic space is not entered, therefore minimizing the risk of bleeding with this dissection. When utilizing a graft, an attempt should be made to keep the vaginal skin flaps thicker than one would use for traditional repair.
History is made of flesh, forever altered by the insidious process of decomposition. In as little as 10 years, the skin of the corpse begins to loosen and sag, turning to liquid and toxic gas, or in extreme conditions, drying to a mummified mask. The bones, even in a well-made casket, remain whole only for a few hundred years.
Thank you. conducted. Identifications can be made through dental records. What we find in a classic spontaneous human combustion scene is not even that much to analyze.
Bodies has been concealed, and none of the victims has been robbed, but all of them have the same horrific trademark injury, a vodka bottle or stick forced into the bloody, gaping wound at the back of the head.
The ability to be free living in the soil, usually from a fecal contaminated soil, and it burrows its way through the skin, making its way into the small blood vessels, and eventually can enter into the lungs.
From there, they climb up the bronchial tube and are swallowed back down into the gut. In the small bowel, they molt twice and become adult female worms. The females thread themselves in and out of the lining of the small bowel, causing inflammation. Strongyloides is a killer. It can cause major tissue damage, acute respiratory failure, and eventually death.
Thank you. suburethral incision is made underneath the urethra, starting approximately 1 centimeter distal urethra meatus down toward the bladder neck. The incision is made for approximately 1.5 to 2 centimeters. The vaginal epithelium is then dissected off the underlying suburethral tissues enough to be able to get a finger in to palpate the sidewall. The finger is then dissected out laterally just to the other side of the descending issue pubic ramus to be able to palpate the sidewall on each side.
Monday, and look what they did to him. He's only 3 feet long. He must still weigh 200 pounds. What's all this yellow shit coming out of his head?